Hello everyone, this is Reverend Paul Phelps with Miracles One. I'd like to welcome you to my Christmas sharing for this year. When I was preparing for this, as I always do, I take some time to go and connect with Jesus and with the Holy Spirit. And I always ask, I say, okay, what is the message that you want me to share with folks for each of these recordings? And one thing that's really nice about that experience is that during that time, I really feel this connection with them. And it's really interesting to have a conversation or a dialogue or just to quietly listen and allow the flow of information to kind of come to me, because they share with me all these really neat perspectives and stories. And the biggest thing I worry about is when I come out of that state to be able to reshare that information with everyone out there who may be watching these videos. So anyways, when I first started to go into my connection, I got a vision of Santa Claus. And I was reminded about the wonderful myth of Santa Claus that we share with our children, and the whole experience of that during my childhood, the enthusiasm and the excitement that I had and experienced as a child with this idea that this wonderful, jolly man dressed up in a suit of red and white would, you know, this idea of him taking time all year long to prepare presents for not only myself, but all of the other children around the world. And then after all this lengthy preparation of all these gifts, on one night, he would distribute those gifts to all of the children. And as a child, you know, we believed these stories, and they were really a lot of fun, especially on Christmas morning, when you get up and you're excited, and if you have brothers and sisters, they're excited too, and everybody you know, scrambles to find the presents at the Christmas tree, and there's just a lot of joy associated with that. And it's a fun time for many, many years. Eventually though, and oh yeah, there's a magic about all of this. And, you know, the magic, you know, part of the magic is that this individual, Santa Claus, loves us unconditionally. And well, supposedly there's a naughty and nice list, but I've always gotten presents, even when I was naughty. So apparently he loved us unconditionally. And, you know, there was a wonderful magic about that. That sense of love and joy and kind of the temporary setting aside of the things that made our lives challenging, whatever that may have been for us in those years of our lives. So, but invariably what happens over time, as we get older, we eventually learn that the myth of Santa Claus is not true. And I know for myself, I was somewhat disappointed about that. And you know, what else did we have? You know, and part of the disappointment is, what do we have to look forward to now? You know, if that's not really true and it's not lasting, that, you know, the magic kind of disappears. It just kind of vanishes, melts away or whatever. And if you think about it, the gifts, you know, when we receive the gifts as children over a couple of weeks, whether you're visiting relatives and friends, eventually, you know, that peters out too. And the magic of the joy that was around that and associated with receiving those gifts, it goes away. It's not timeless. And, so that can kind of lead into some depression for some folks, or at least some sadness. And there's, you know, you have to learn how to cope with this as you're growing up as a teenager and young adult. And some, I suppose, some handle it better than others. But you're kind of, if you really think about it, I think many of us are left in a place where we thought there was a presence there that loved us, that would come around and share gifts with us, was there and was real, and then you find out it's not, then you kind of, there's almost like a void there. You know, what else do you have to look forward to? And I think for many, as you continue to grow up into adults, you begin to replace that, the joy, you try to replace that joy or substitute that joy in different ways. And for, you know, some people may start to drink too much during the holidays, or eat too much during the holidays, or go out and spend too much money during the holidays to try to recapture some of that magic. And unfortunately, for many, it, you know, it creates depression and underlying depression and sadness, because it's not fulfilling, it's not true, and there's always something missing. There's a sense of peace about it, and a lack of fulfillment that's always missing. And we may get caught up in the busyness and distract ourselves from feeling that in those different ways. But there's always this underlying lingering sense of, I think, maybe even some loneliness and sadness that goes along with it, because we're missing the true sense of peace and the true sense of inner joy and connectedness with ourselves, with God, and with each other. Because for many of us, we hadn't found it. We hadn't figured it out by that point. So the message that Jesus wanted me to share with you, and for me, is the reminder that there's something else available, and he has a gift for us. If we haven't found it, or maybe have forgotten about it, he has a special Christmas gift for us this year, right now. And I'm sharing that, you know, what I'm going to share that with you right now. What is that gift? And he's waiting to give it to you. The Holy Spirit is waiting to give it to you. So if we think about it, if you're a course student, you know that Jesus has been a big time advocate about working with the Holy Spirit and learning how to work with the Holy Spirit, learning how to connect with him. And he wants you to think of Holy Spirit as, you know, the substitute for Santa Claus, but the Holy Spirit is eternal. And the Holy Spirit has prepared a limitless amount of gifts for us, and he is anxiously waiting to share them with us. He's prepared them, and just like Santa Claus did, but his gifts, as I mentioned, are eternal, and they're never going to go away. And he's excited too. And he's standing there. He's with us. As we know from the teachings in the Course in Miracles, when we went into the belief of separation from the Creator, from God, from Father, from Mother, we went into this experience that we're having now where we believe we're separated. And when that happened, Father created the Holy Spirit to help us to recover from that. And the Holy Spirit is inside of us in a very literal sense. Of course, the Miracles tells us that many times. But that is meaningless until you actually start to experience it for yourself. And so we have this Holy Spirit inside of us. He has all these gifts that he's waiting to give us. What we need to do is to learn how to open up to receiving those gifts and to actually want them, to even just experience one of them. And if you haven't experienced them yet, that's what he's offering right now. He's either offering for those of you who really haven't, you know, either you have experienced some miracles or mystical experiences where you couldn't explain something, or you have, either have or you have not. And he's offering for both right now, either a reminder for those who have, and for those who have not, a really special Christmas gift this year, which is an experience of undeniability. Okay. And he told me this, he wants you to know, I guess I'm the messenger here, that, if you try this with him, he promises to deliver. So thank you, Jesus. appreciate the backup on that. So, anyway, so here's the deal. So, for those of you who are skeptics, or for those of you who would like a reminder, I'd like you to have a little bit of willingness this Christmas to try something new. And this is about freeing yourselves forever, or taking a step in that direction too, because this is the kind of gift that is eternal. And once you experience it, once it kicks in, you will never forget it, at least during this lifetime. And you're going to want more of it. And these gifts from the Holy Spirit are the kind of gifts that we can receive every day. Once we get the hang of it, once we learn how to go within and get connected and to begin to ask him to help us with our lives. And it truly is a wonderful experience. I've been working with A Course in Miracles myself for many years now. And over the years, I've gotten better and better at making it a habit to consult with the Holy Spirit, consult with Jesus, to ask him for help. And I cannot tell you over the years, I cannot tell you how it is. the climb up the ladder of joy is amazing. Many years ago, I was a classic case of hitting rock bottom depression. You know, I was ready to crawl up into a ball and die. I did not want to live anymore. And it was at that point in my life where I began to turn to a higher power for help that I didn't know. And I began to ask. And once we begin to ask with all of our hearts, our heart, mind, and soul, he answers. He is waiting to answer and to acknowledge and to give us messages and to give us signs and to give us miracles. And as we have that willingness to start trying, things start to happen. Your lives start to turn around. And the more effort you put into it, the bigger your return is. So, but right now, we're just asking for a lot of you who have maybe have forgotten or who have slacked off to consider taking some time with me now and then on your own after we do this meditation to continue to reach out and ask for an undeniable experience that A, you're not alone. That you're really not alone, and that there's this wonderful, jolly, happy presence with us that is going to give us a gift. And then we're going to ask him for a gift, an undeniable gift, something that when it happens, we are amazed or we feel joy. Who knows? The Holy Spirit knows exactly what the best thing is for you to experience at this time in your life right now. So all I'm asking you to consider doing is just try this. Try this with all your heart so that this upcoming year may be a totally different year for you from the last year. and potentially a year that can maybe be bringing you up out of the spiral of depression, who knows, and rejuvenating that magical feeling that you have in your life that we once had when we were children, with when we were had the experience of Santa Claus and receiving the gifts. But the difference with this one is this one's not going to change. It will never be taken away from us. And as we learn to grow and use this gift and receive these gifts, we will be blessed with things that we can use. He can use us to help others within the world. And so there are, for those of you out there who are already awakened to either a moderate degree, a great degree, this is a reminder to continue to receive your gifts and allow yourself to be a channel, to be used to pass those gifts along to others. There are many out there around us who are still suffering. They're in misery, and because they've lost their Santa Claus. And we because we're already awakened a little bit, we have the ability to say, all right, Holy Spirit, how can I be truly helpful to this person? What would you have me do? Where would you have me go? What would you have me say, and to whom? And he will tell us. I just had this experience the other day where my sister asked me to reach out and help my nephew who was struggling with chronic depression. And I, my relationship with him, it's a long distance relationship, and he's more of an acquaintance than a real close nephew. Because of a long distance relationship and other factors. So I went and connected with Jesus and with Holy Spirit, and I said, hey, okay, I really want to try to help this young man out. You know, what would you have me say to him? What would you have me do? And I was, I received information that I didn't expect to receive, but I shared it. And when I shared it, my nephew responded with like, oh my God, I can't believe you said that kind of stuff, because that's exactly what I just experienced. And I don't believe in coincidences. And I'm like, yes, thank you. Because I was reaching out. And if you're not careful, as you know, with the younger generation, if there's a age gap, you can easily turn off the younger generation. So, but if we got the Holy Spirit on our side and we're really truly listening, he will help us out. And now this individual is opening up, and I could tell that his spirit was already lifted. So not only did I receive a gift by having the willingness to ask for a gift to give to him, my nephew received a gift as well. And it's a gift of awakening for all of us. And it's a gift of joy. I felt joy. He felt joy. And the Holy Spirit invariably feels joy. And this is what it's about. This is how we can be miracle workers in our everyday lives within this world. So with that said, I'd like to invite all of you right now to join with me in receiving a Christmas gift from Jesus and from the Holy Spirit. So we're going to take a little bit of time in meditation here, and I'm going to just kind of tune in. And so if you would, please go ahead and wherever you are, hopefully you're in a position where you can just get yourselves relaxed and into a comfortable position, and without distraction. So let's just go ahead. We're going to go ahead and do this right now. So if, go ahead and take a few deep breaths with me, and we're just going to allow ourselves to begin to relax and sink down. Relax and sink down. With each exhale, allow your body to just melt into relaxation and peace. Feel all the any and all tension just melting away. You want to become very, very relaxed. And if we have a busy mind, busy thoughts, let's settle those down as well. Perhaps imagine seeing a pond of water in front of you, and you may see some ripples going across the pond, and the ripples are representative of our thoughts. So allow that pond to become calm now as we set all of our thoughts aside, and we're just going to continue to sink down into a peaceful, quiet, silent space where we quieted our thoughts for just a moment. And as we rest in this space, this quiet, peaceful place, with an open mind, and a quiet mind. The open and quiet mind is in a space of receptivity to receive a gift from the Holy Spirit as He reaches into his bag, His Christmas bag. He's going to hand us a gift, and maybe we can even see an image of this gift in our mind's eye right now, just materializing. Aha. So, yes, see that gift. I see one with a bow on it right now. It's like a box. So the Holy Spirit is handing all of us a gift right now, and our gift is unique. It's unique for each and every one of us. So continue to focus on this gift you're receiving right now. Allow it to come a little bit more clearly into your mind's eye or imagination. Perhaps you can hold your hands out. You can hold your hands out to receive this gift. And you may even feel the presence of it as it's being set down into your hands. Oh, it's a nice gift. And see the colors of the wrapping. And those are special colors for you. Your favorite Christmas colors. And it's got a wonderful bow on it. Perhaps you see some other decoration. Thank the Holy Spirit for your gift. Thank you. And when you're ready, open your gift. Just go ahead and open your gift when you're ready and see what's inside. This is your reminder. This is your reminder to join with Him in the Great Awakening. It's our invitation. So, yeah. Okay, now let's thank the Holy Spirit for that gift. And we're invited to ask Him now for a undeniable experience of his presence with us, with you. So when you're ready, just go ahead and ask him, you know, Holy Spirit, thank you for your gift, and I truly want to have a personal experience where I'm reminded that you are with me and I am not alone. And, you know, we want to work together. I want you to help me with my life. I want you to help me to improve my life so that I may become a happier, more peaceful being of service here for you and for myself and for others. Because this is the path to true joy and peace. A sense of altruism, a sense of service. I have forgotten, or I've had trouble connecting and seeing your signs and your messages. And so now I ask you with all my heart to give me a sign, a special sign this Christmas, just for me. Thank you. Thank you. I really want this. Thank you so much. Amen. And so, when you are ready, let's slowly bring our attention back to wherever we are, remembering the gift and the connection we just made with him. Bring that back with you so that you can reflect on that later. And if you felt like you were distracted a little bit in the moment, I'd like to invite you to go ahead and practice this on your own. Find that space where you can go and sit down and spend a little bit of time with the Holy Spirit and ask him to help you with facilitating some new significant change in your life, to bring that joy and that magic of Christmas back once and for all and forever. And so I thank you all for joining with me. If you have any questions and you'd like to reach out to us here at MiraclesOne, please go to our website at www.miraclesone.org, and you can find our email addresses there. I'd love to hear from you. I'd love to connect with you and answer your questions if you have any, or just to help support you in reaching out and making your connection and getting that Christmas gift, which we just took that first little step in doing. And also, I'd like to remind you to pay attention now, because it's going to happen. So pay attention. And that undeniable experience is coming your way. Pay attention to your dreams. Pay attention to what's going on around you. And something's going to happen. I believe that with all my heart. I've experienced it many times myself. And I wish you all a very Merry Christmas. God bless. Oh.